Can We Talk? I'm Michelle.
And I'm Lynn.
And yes, we can.
Talk.
So we're going to talk a little bit, okay? So what kind of day did you have today, Lynn?
I had a very hectic day.
Did you?
I did.
Must be a Scorpio thing.
Maybe so. But anyway, so now here we are on Friday night.
Yeah.
With all the wonderful people of Richmond.
Did you work today?
Welcome.
You baked today?
I baked today.
Ah, Auntie Lynn's Homespun Bakery was busy with good smells and treats. I see you made some really cute little
funfetti cookies and funfetti cookie pops.
Very interesting.
Something different.
That is different. It smells good. It smells really good. So yeah, I had a different kind of day today. I did help out at the cafeteria in the elementary school.
That was fun.
Oh, it was very busy. And it was their pajama day. So they were all in pajamas. The teachers were in pajamas. Even the principal was in pajamas. I didn't wear pajamas because I was afraid. I thought, well, what if I get pulled over? And I'm in pajamas. They might think I'm some kind of wacko and send me somewhere. I don't know. But that was not really the craziest part of my day.
At least it wasn't crazy pajama day.
A funny thing happened to me on the way to the show. It's so cliche. But actually, I was getting ready for the show. Uh-huh. And Cora, my little granddaughter, she had to go to dance class. Well, you know, I keep Jimmy and Cora after school. And so it's my responsibility to get her to the dance class. And I thought Dad would be coming to pick her up. Well, he didn't show up. She's supposed to be there at 5:30, so at 5:32, I said, come on, we're going. Because if she misses any dance classes, then she doesn't get her little ribbon at the recital for perfect attendance. Anyway, so off we go, and then I get a call from Dad saying, where are you?
He was at your house?
No, he was at the dance studio. And so I left Jimmy back at the house, which meant that I had to drop Cora off. There were no parking spaces, so I couldn't even send Dad to go get Jimmy. I had to go back to the house, grab Jimmy, back on over to the dance studio. It was just back and forth, back and forth. And then put on makeup on the way.
I hope it looks okay. You look great. Fine.
I was concerned.
Talking about dancing,
yeah?
Have you seen that new, well, I guess it's the second season now of that crazy show on Lifetime, Dance Moms?
Oh, yeah, I did. I showed it to Cora.
Was she scared?
She's so glad that Miss Barbara is her dance instructor, not that one. But what I was getting to, too, is, you know, we always talk about relationships on Can We Talk? That's our thing. We feature local talent, which we have a real treat for everyone this evening. But I wanted to talk about relationships and communication, because that is truly the key. Had he communicated with me, I wouldn't have had such a crazy evening. And this is, you know, an ongoing thing. And I'm sure that other grandparents who watch their kids now, that's a very popular thing now.
Right.
The grandkids, you know, they'll maybe take them to school, pick them up from school, and they, you know, stay for a while. But, the parents need to communicate with us.
Communication is
essential. We have a life, too. It may not be as fast. But, you know, we'd like to make plans and all that. And I hope he's watching.
Well, it's a great thing, too, that there's more grandparents that are able to spend time with the kids. And
I think so.
For the kids and the grandparents.
It's very helpful. It's helpful in relationships. And we're getting ready to do a three-part series on runaway youth and teens. And so, yeah, communication is the key.
It is.
And so I have personal experience with that. And so that is one of my heartfelt topics. And so I thought maybe we can get somebody from the Department of Health or from one of the different organizations to come on the show and talk a little bit about, you know, how we can prevent runaways. And, you know, I actually read that there are more than 1 million teens from the age 14 through 17 who run away each year, run away from home. So I thought that was something we really should try to cover. And of course, if any of our viewers are facing a situation like that or are concerned about that, it would be great for them to call in.
And I found out some of the top reasons why teens do run away. So hopefully we'll be able to discuss that too.
Well, go for it.
You want to do it now?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what I found out is family dynamics, peer issues, school problems, being bullied in school, mm-hmm. just not making the grade, substance mm-hmm. abuse,
right,
pregnancy, physical and emotional abuse at home,
right,
mental health issues, looking for attention, sexual, because of their sexual orientation, if they're not
right.
what's considered
What site
normal.
Did you find that on? Do you know?
I don't. I did not write that down.
I read a lot of those same things.
And they also leave to join a friend, and because they don't want to obey the rules and stuff at home. Mm-hmm. And some of the things they do while they're out there to survive, they steal, they beg, sell drugs, prostitution, and dumpster dive.
And of course, they become targets, don't they? They become targets who prey on young people.
Well, I know when I was younger, I went to Florida for a little while.
And I remember that.
And I was 18 or 19, whatever it was, and I met up with a bunch of people that were runaways and kind of street kids. And what they did was they would go for a tourist, and they would basically beat them up and mug them for money. To survive.
And what did you do?
Nothing. I didn't even watch it.
You came home.
Yeah, I came home.
I remember.
I didn't run away.
Well, I found a site. It was the National Runaway Switchboard. It's a 1-800-RUNAWAY. And they have a lot of information regarding youth. It's not just teens. There are youth also who run away and they fall prey to and victimized by pedophiles. Mm-hmm. Or just people who would exploit them and rape them and do all kinds of terrible things to them. And kids don't always think about the consequences of running away. You know, they're targeted, they're focused on whatever it is that they're feeling that's making them want to run
right.
away from home, rather than thinking about, you know, well, what would happen when I'm out there on the street? How am I going to eat?
Right.
And all that. And usually I think they wind up going from home to home to home with their friends.
Maybe, if they have, if they're able to.
And anyway.
And one of the best ways for a parent or somebody that's responsible for a teen to prevent them from running away from home is just to keep an open and stable relationship with that teen.
Which is not always so easy because teens are a really difficult stage of life.
Yep.
And so, but yeah, watch for signs and try to keep communications, open communications the key.
Yes, it is.
To every relationship.
It is.
You know, it starts, if you're taking your kids to daycare, it starts with the daycare provider.
Right.
Right.
And I actually have some of those signs they say to look out for written down with me.
Okay.
So you want any of those now or?
Go for it.
If you're noticing that your teen is, smoking, drinking alcohol, using drugs, they drop in their grades or their interests.
Mm-hmm.
They're not participating in their daily activities.
Right.
Acting out in sexual matters. If they threat to run away, if they become aggressive or they start stealing, depressed, negative, they talk about death, they make threats about harming themselves or someone else.
Mm.
It's all signs that your teen might be in trouble.
Right. Wow, and it's so hard to tell too because teens are so rebellious anyway.
Yeah. And they say that you can get help for them from like a county health department mm-hmm. or local mental health association, local medical and hospital that has psychiatric services.
I did invite somebody from the health department
to
come
good.
And be a
that's
guest.
That's good. Psychiatrist.
For a future show.
Psychologist, social worker. You can talk with parents, teachers, friends.
Oh, that's a good idea. I met while I was working in the cafeteria this afternoon, I did meet the school guidance counselor. Maybe I could invite her to be a guest.
Yep, you can also speak with the primary doctor.
But those are young kids. Those are the elementary school.
It doesn't matter. They still know. She's still a guidance
right.
counselor.
I'll check
and then there's many national organizations that someone can call if they need help.
Right, okay. Well, that's good. Wow. And, you know, we do have, as I said before, we feature... Somebody asked me today, why do you feature talent on your show? Why don't you just talk on the show? And what I said was, people really don't want to sit and watch a show of talking for a whole hour, number one. And number two, because I feel as though I'm giving not just our viewers the opportunity to see some of their local talent, although that's part of it, but also because there are some awesome, awesome singers and talented people right here in Richmond, Virginia, and they don't always get a chance to really, you know,
right.
show what they've got.
And this is a great way to do that.
Yeah, and we've got somebody this evening who is, I think, a superstar, okay? I posted a link on Facebook for, I think it was from her page from Reverb Nation, and she's, you know, singing on that link. And people from Texas, California, Canada, and of course in the, you know, in Virginia, all commented on that link. Everybody loved her. And so this is an opportunity for her to be seen and to really wow Richmond. Yeah. So I think that that's a wonderful way for us to give back to the community a little bit.
And what is her name?
Her name is Evelyn Quaye, but I'm not ready to introduce her just yet. I'm going to make them wait just a couple of minutes, okay? And so we're talking about relationships, communication being the key. We're talking about runaways, and that's going to be a three-part series, and I'm hoping that people will call us with some input. You know, maybe they know something we don't. From personal experience, I can tell you there are many things that runaways go through, and there are many reasons that runaways do run, and I can tell you that from personal experience because I was a teenage runaway.
And why did you run away?
Well, for more than one reason, and you know there probably is more than one reason for most kids, but for me it was because I really did not trust adults. I didn't trust adults. I didn't believe that they knew what was best for me. I thought I knew what was best for me. I was raised by my grandparents, and they were pretty strict, and so I didn't like a lot of the rules that they set down for me. And I had been abandoned by my parents as a, well, I was like about 9.5 years old, and so I didn't trust anybody. And so I thought I knew better, and so I ran. I lived in New York at the time, so I ran to some friends in Brooklyn, and I did go from house to house to house to house. And I ran into a lot of different situations that I couldn't handle. You know, I was basically on the streets. I was 14 years old. And I had my first job at 14 years old at a donut shop downtown Brooklyn. I had myself a little one room, could call it an apartment. It was kind of like a studio, small studio. And, you know, lied about my age and everything like that. And so, yeah, you can really get yourself into a lot of hot water. So if there are any teens or any, you know, people watching the show right now who are contemplating running away or who have ran away and would like somebody to talk to who's been there and knows about it, give me a call. And you don't have to be on the air if you don't want to be. You know, you can email me at onedisciple@aol.com, onedisciple@aol.com, and I'd be glad to communicate with you, right? Communication's the key, and that can really save you from a lot of heartache, a lot of grief, and it might even save your life. So be smart, okay? I think I am one adult that a lot of kids and a lot of teens really do relate to, and they find easy to talk to me, pretty much. I had a daycare for 14 years, you know, and some of my daycare kids who are adults now are still in touch with me. And,
you married a couple of them, right?
I married a couple of them, yeah. Well, I'm a wedding minister. A lot of people don't know that, but a lot of our viewers know that already. And in fact, one of the couples who I married, she was in my daycare, the bride, I wound up with her little boy in my daycare.
So,
yeah, when you do a business for 14 years, you know, you grow as you watch the others grow. Anyway, I am sure that our viewers are waiting to see this spectacular talent that I was talking about. And Evelyn Quaye has also brought a wonderful guitarist. His name is Christopher Andrews. And without further ado, if they're ready, I would like to introduce Evelyn Quaye and Christopher Andrews. Take it away.
Cigarette holder, which wigs me over my shoulder. He digs me out, cats in my satin doll. Baby, shall we go? Out stepping, careful, amigo. You're flipping, speaks Latin, my satin doll. He's nobody's fool, so I'm playing it cool as can be. I'll give it a whirl, but I ain't for no boy catching me. Switcheroo, need telephone numbers. Well, you know I'm doing my rumbas. Ooh, with Uno, speaks Latin, my satin dog. Phone numbers, well, you know I'm doing my rumbas. Ooh, with Uno, speaks Latin, my satin doll. Ooh, oh, oh, yes, out catting my satin doll. Scooby da beep boop bop, speaks Latin, my satin doll. Yes. Yes. I'm gonna sing an original, "The Sound of the Rain." It's a song that I wrote in 2010.
All right.
Very cool.
Please do.
Thank you. The sound of the rain freezes and burns like cold black snow. I said the sound of the rain freezes and burns like cold black snow. When my baby has let me down and I haven't no other place to go, the sound of the rain wraps its cold arms around me tight. It's got me tied in its arms. Oh, when I think I'm gonna give up that fight. 'Cause that cold, cold rain ain't letting me out of its sight. I feel so alone, cold and empty in all that black snow. My baby, he let me down. Oh, he let me down just when I needed him so. And so when I hear the sound of the rain, I've got to pack up my bags and go. The sound of the rain freezes and burns like cold black snow. I said the sound of the rain freezes and burns like cold, 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 cold black snow. When my baby has let me down and I haven't no other place to go.
That is wonderful. Wow.
Excuse me, I'm so
the
sorry.
Soulful sounds of Evelyn Quaye and guitarist Christopher Andrews. Thank you so much.
Thank
oh, we
you.
Hope you'll sing again later for us. Everybody's got to wait now for that, so don't go anywhere. All right. Wow, I told you, Richmond, Virginia's got talent, right?
Really does.
I say
Absolutely.
That all over Facebook, and it's so true.
And where did you find Evelyn?
I think I found her on Facebook. I've been looking for talent, local talent. And so there she is. And she's
awesome.
Fabulous. Yes. And we have a cousin in Canada who is he's just lost his mind over her.
I know. And if people
he wants her there.
If people want to see her play, is there a play any places?
Reverb Nation. And she also has, we'll get her to tell
Can
everybody
tell us about
in a little
it later.
While.
That mm-hmm. sounds good. That sounds good.
Yeah, because she's going to, I think she's appearing tomorrow.
Exciting.
Yeah, I'm going to have her tell you about it.
All right, that sounds good.
And okay, that's some soulful sounding right there. We need to get back to relationships, right? And I think even, you know, all the songs are geared toward relationships. And that's why when we started doing Can We Talk, and we talked about it, thought that relationships is that would be a good topic because everybody has a relationship with someone, and it doesn't have to mean that it's a romantic relationship, but you have a relationship, I don't care if it's with your landlord or your next door neighbor,
even with your pets,
and your pastor or people at church or
your doctor.
Somebody who's serving you food in a restaurant
mm-hmm.
for that little
Absolutely.
Period of time, there's a relationship there.
Absolutely.
Sometimes too much, huh? Yeah, I don't like it when the food server sits down at the table and starts talking to you.
Well, I was somewhere and that happened.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I can't remember exactly what it was.
I had, I won't say what restaurant I was in, but I was there with my husband. And this particular waitress, you know, she was very good, very efficient, but every time she came to the table, she called him honey or sweetie.
Or, that bothered you?
It bothered me. And I said to her, would you please stop calling my husband all these terms of endearment? I call him those names.
Right.
And she was, ooh. But she didn't do it anymore. I haven't seen her there.
There are some people that's just how they talk.
Not to my husband.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't think so. And, you know, she was a very good food server and everything like that, but I just didn't appreciate that.
Did you leave her a tip?
Well, he paid, so. I think we might have a call. That'd be nice. Somebody who's going to talk about relationships. Or maybe they want to just talk about Evelyn Quaye, how great she sounded.
Maybe.
Right? And I think she was just getting warmed up, too. That second song. That was really good. Anyhow, so we were talking about Runaways. Back to Runaways. You got a lot of information. And I got a little information. For the Volunteer Emergency Families for Children in Richmond, there's an 800 number. It's 1-800-756-6167. Or their local number is 379-7767. So if you are experiencing any kind of problem with your teen or youth that you think maybe you need to... Yeah, sometimes you really just don't know what to do. Right?
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if you mentioned before that sometimes runaways are those who have been kicked out of the house.
Mm-hmm.
They're the throwaway kids, right?
Yeah.
For whatever the reason. And so, you know, those are kids in need right there. And there are places that will help them. If you are a runaway, if you see this show and you feel like you need a warm place to stay or some food, there are places in Richmond that you can call. And that's one of them, the Volunteer Emergency Families for Children in Richmond.
And also too, a lot of times if you contact a church,
mm-hmm.
you know, if you just find yourself out there, you know, not knowing what to do or who to go to, If you're near a church, just go into the church and they'll help you out too. They may not have food right there for you or have something for you right there.
They can contact
but right, they, somebody. Yeah, mm-hmm. they'll help you. Mm. So there are a lot of resources and a lot of
right.
help that you can get.
And I don't know how many there are, but I know that there was a statistic too for those who have run away who commit suicide. Mm-hmm. And so this is a very tragic and pressing topic, something important, though, that we really need to have people aware of and you know, like I said, too, maybe get somebody on the show as a guest speaker who right. is involved in runaways. And you know who I saw on this show? Not yeah. on our show, not on Can We Talk, but on this channel, on Channel 95.
Who is that?
Joe Marcy.
Uh-huh.
I was telling Jesse to go to his office for a job.
I know, he told me about that.
I've always liked Joe Marcy.
I believe he's getting ready to be
delegate.
Reinstated, unless he has already.
Oh, he's been reinstated. He's out there.
Yeah,
he's
that
out
was
there.
Recently, because they were talking about it on the news.
Mm. He's out there stirring reinstated. Trouble again. You know, he likes to do that. He's the rebel. And I say that in a good way, because I like him. I actually put his name on ballot on I don't know, maybe
you wrote him
a few years ago.
I wrote his name
on a ballot for, I don't know what it was, governor or something. But, yeah, he's back. Go Joe. Yeah.
You know, I had gotten
keep
some...
Keep a good man down.
I had gotten some feedback because, you know, on the last show we were saying if anybody had any ideas or suggestions to send an email. Mm-hmm. Well, someone was emailed me and basically said that a lot of teens feel invincible. Mm-hmm. And you hear of a lot of teen disappearances and things. Mm-hmm. And they were asking if maybe we could go over some street smarts. And I think it applies to not only teens, but to just about everybody.
Right.
And so some things that I found was one of the most important things to do is to stay alert, know your surroundings, send out a message that you're calm and you're confident and that you know where you're going. Walk like you know where you're going. You should stick to well-traveled streets. Avoid wooded areas.
You'd think that's all common sense, right? But some people don't
do that. Yeah, but not everybody thinks that. Stay away from alleys. Right. Actually, I knew somebody. It was like 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, and they were like, I think she was 20 years old at the time.
They have to cultivate that. Don't mess with me, walk.
Okay? Right.
Well, and don't look anybody in the eyes. Walk, you know. I mean, of course, yeah. Know your surroundings. Know who's behind you, in front of you, whatever. And like, you know, for me now, I've reached a point in my life where I actually do take my keys out before I walk outside, you know, for the car. And I, you know, like I observe a lot of those safety precautions. I try to park in a well-lit spot. And even if it, you know, I'm at the supermarket, even though the parking lot is crowded, you know, I will be very careful. And you know, they say that you're supposed to, you know, lock your doors mm-hmm. when you get into your vehicle. You should check and make sure nobody's in there. Imagine getting into your vehicle and you check and somebody is there. What would you do? What would you do?
Take my key and break it in their face if I could. Whatever you have, scream really loud, scream fire, not help.
I don't know, they're already in there, so that's kind of scary, right?
Right, but hopefully if you keep it locked, they won't be in there, but they still get in there, because look what happened at our house.
What happened?
Oh, well, the truck, Matt's truck, was locked, and somebody broke into his truck. Yeah, they didn't break the window, they pried the door open. Mm. And they took all of his, he kept his hunting stuff in there.
Oh, man.
And so they took his gun and they took all kinds of things from
there.
They
took a shotgun, right?
Yeah.
That's messed up.
Yeah. At like 8:30 in the evening.
And knives?
Yeah,
and what did the police do?
They came and took a report. Told him he could go look at some of the pawn shops in the area.
Mm.
Gave him the name of some stores that buy stolen goods. I guess they don't buy them knowing that they're stolen, but
they're kind of limited as to what they
can
do.
Yeah, what can they do? They can't go knock on everybody's door and say, you know.
He was a little frustrated that they didn't take fingerprints.
Yeah. But it is what it is, so.
Yeah.
And then I think most people know not to accept rides from strangers.
Don't keep your gun or any firearms or anything in your vehicle overnight. Mm-hmm. Don't keep your wallet there. Don't keep any valuables, even though you may live in what you believe to be such a nice, calm, and quiet neighborhood. stuff happens, yeah. right? In the best places and the worst.
Right.
So you have to really be careful.
Know the neighborhood that you live in. Mm-hmm. Know the areas. You know, the neighborhood you go to school in, you work in. Know where there's fire and police stations located. Mm-hmm. Know what
That's
stores.
A lot of homework.
Know what stores and restaurants may stay open late in case right. you're walking around and you've got to find a safe place to go. Don't ever display a lot of cash. And when you're walking around with a backpack or your purse, keep it close to your body. And like you were saying before, when you're getting ready to go to your car or go to your house, have your key in your hand.
Right.
Because not only does it get you in there quicker if
it's
you had to.
It's a good weapon if you need
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you can just kind of jab people mm-hmm. if you have to.
Right.
Keep your wallet in your front pocket and always trust your instincts. If you feel like something's not quite right, it's probably not, and get out of that area.
I'm going to tell you about just a very short little story. Something that happened to me many years ago in Brooklyn, okay? And, okay, so I had a date. This is long before I was married. I was a teen. Anyway, so we were coming out of a neighborhood bar, okay? We had been in the bar. I guess I must have been, I don't know, 18, 19. Anyhow, so I probably shouldn't have been in there, but I was. So went outside, and we walked across the street, and all of a sudden these guys, jumped my date, right? So I'm standing there and freaked out and, you know, crazy teen also. And, you know, I jumped on one of their backs, you know, like piggyback style. I jumped on him and I started hitting him and everything and screaming. And he said, "Man, this girl's crazy. Let's get out of here." And they ran away. Now, I'm not saying that everybody should right. do something like that. But, you know, later in life, before I was a minister, way before, I'm saying like 20-something years ago, I wound up lieutenant for a security company right here in Richmond. So, you know, sometimes you have to fight back, but I guess if they have a weapon, maybe not so much.
How about when we were in Las Vegas and we had just gotten there, mm-hmm. and it was so hot there that most of the homeless people, at least the area that we were in,
right,
they slept during the day.
Right, all those people who lost their shirts in the casinos.
They
right?
would so they would sleep during the day, and then in the evening, they wake up because it's cooler. And we right. were walking across the street or whatever to one of the casinos, and like every place, like where there were bushes or something,
they started standing up.
They started standing up. It was
like
something
zombies.
Out of Night of the Living Dead.
And what did I do? I said, "Just link my arm, right?" Yeah.
Well,
and your brother was with us, and so we linked arms, the three of us, strong, right? The street we went. Nobody bothered us.
No, they probably wouldn't have bothered us anyway.
And that's why. But that's why I say, you know, put on your "don't mess with me" walk.
Right.
Okay. If you look tough, they might go to somebody
Those
else.
Cookies smell really good. Every
they
once
do.
In a
they
while,
smell
I keep
great.
Getting like a whiff of them.
It's we'll
pretty
have
funny.
To have some later.
Later.
Okay. After the show, everybody will get some cookies. But yeah, and so communication being the key. I communicated with those guys.
Right.
They left. Lucky. That was so lucky. But hey, you got to do what you got to do. And you do have to be careful. And I'm thinking, I keep thinking of the teens, the runaways that are out there, and like on a cold night.
Like tonight?
Mm-hmm. And they hang out in any doorway or any place they feel like they can, you know, get some
into,
shelter.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I really hope that somebody is listening now who will call that National Runaway Switchboard, NRS, at 1-800-RUNAWAY, because they'll help them.
Right.
You know? And things are a lot different today than from when I was a teen.
Yeah.
When I was a teen, I mean, yeah, there still were crazies out there and everything like that, but not like today.
Yeah.
Today they have all kinds of different ways to trick you and you know.
Get you hooked into something that you
Get you hooked on, yeah. Oh, that reminds me of that movie. Did
Which
you see
one?
That movie, Taken?
Yeah, that was really
with
good.
Liam Neeson.
Ooh. That was good, but she wasn't a runaway. She was on vacation.
Can happen.
Well, I know. She got kidnapped.
Yeah, she was
that
lucky
was
she had a father who knew who had special skills, right?
Then it was Hollywood.
He said that. He said, "If you let my daughter go now, then, you know, I'll forget about this. But if you don't let her go, I just want you to know I have some special skills.
That was a good movie.
And I will hunt you down.
I
will find you."
Yeah, I enjoyed that movie.
That was so cool.
Talking of movies, I saw that, and I think you saw it too, that movie War Horses.
Oh, that was such a good movie.
If you haven't seen that movie and you can only go see
War
that movie,
Horse,
go see
it was
that movie.
War Horse. It was a really good movie.
I cried.
We went for our anniversary.
I cried.
We went for our anniversary. I thought, I read about it and everything, and I said, oh, this would be a good anniversary movie, because we usually go and see like crazy movies, horror
right.
movies and all that. But it was very
My
good.
My husband, Matt wanted to see that movie, and I was like, go see another movie that's like back during a war, because he's into that stuff. It's like, okay, I'll go.
It had something for everyone.
And then I'm sitting there watching and I'm just glued to it and I'm crying. It was a great movie. I enjoyed
well,
it.
Well, the end of it was kind of, yeah, very touching. Which
I
is
thought the whole thing was really touching.
It was good. It was a good movie. It had it was action-packed.
I got at least three or four times.
It had beautiful horses, beautiful scenery, right? Scenery of Germany and England. I think there was a little bit of Ireland in there, too.
I don't know.
Or maybe not. I don't know. Whatever. There was a brogue in there.
It was good. It was a good movie. There was lots going on.
And I'll tell you what, those horses are very talented.
I'm telling you.
Amazing horses, okay? They play dead and everything. It's very good.
Can't get anything past them.
Yeah, and of course, that movie was all about relationships.
Yeah, it was.
Right?
Especially between
the relationships between the family members, the family dynamics.
And the pet.
And the horse.
I always say that you can have relationships with horse, with pets, and you never go into it with me, but see, there you go.
Wow. Okay, so.
You can't have a relationship with yeah. a pet.
Yes.
I'm done with you.
Communication.
And you can communicate.
He communicated with that horse, didn't he?
He will.
That horse wouldn't, he wouldn't do anything for anybody, but he communicated with that guy. And we won't give the story away. It was very good.
It was a good movie.
Yeah. And so.
Yes.
Back to relationships. Let's do people relationships. Let's do like the relationships that you have with your kids.
Oh, wait, I do want to say one thing I was thinking about earlier. Because you hear a lot of times, I know I've heard a lot of times people complaining about the relationship that they have with their doctors. Oh. That their doctor doesn't listen to them.
Mm.
So,
especially women, right?
Yeah, a lot of times when, especially with women, a lot of times when you're having health problems, mm-hmm. if they can't find a quick fix for it or the quick answer, they just want to dismiss it as stress and give you some kind of an antidepressant.
Yeah, they've been doing that for years.
Well, mm-hmm. you know your body and you know if something is wrong.
Right.
Tell your doctor. Don't be afraid to tell your doctor what, you know, how you're feeling and what you need. And if you feel like you're not getting the kind of care from your doctor, go find another doctor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean.
And what about for people who don't have any medical insurance?
There's a lot of places they can go to, especially in Richmond.
I know you're a good resource for that.
For some things. The Fanfrey Clinic.
Right.
They're a great place to go. You call them and you have to go in for like financial screening.
Is that how you find them? It's called Fanfrey Clinic?
Yep, that's the name of it, Fanfrey Clinic.
Cool.
And they provide excellent services. And actually, I'm sure because they are a nonprofit organization, they can always use the community's help, volunteering or anything that you can you can do.
But they give you free medical care?
They give you free medical care.
Cool.
They give you your prescriptions. You
That's
just
good
have
to know.
To go there.
What about Bon Secours?
They have a van that you can actually go on their website on the internet and look up the Bon Secours care van, I think it is.
Wow.
And it tells you the different locations that they're going to be at, and they'll also take care of you. And I think I heard that they've recently even started dental.
Wow.
So, because I know for adults who may not have insurance and don't have a lot of money, mm-hmm. finding dental care has always been difficult. But I do believe the Bon Secours van is now providing that.
So expensive.
Yeah. Well, through them, it's not. I know in Henrico County, at least, they have a dental clinic for children if they need that.
That's great.
And then also,
how do you find out about all these things?
I listen to the news.
You know, whenever I want to know something, I always call you.
And then VCU, they also have a financial, you can go through their financial screening. And based on your financial screening, you pay on a sliding scale for medical coverage.
That's VCU?
Mm-hmm. VCU. You just have to call them and find out about their programs.
So there are a lot of people without medical insurance right now.
Right. And then also the YMCA, they have a financial program too, because they have the model that everybody should be fit. I'm probably not, that might not be their correct motto, but that everybody should be fit and it doesn't matter if you don't have the money. So they also have a financial program.
Wow.
If you make under a certain amount of money, they'll do your membership on a sliding scale. And then like the
different. So I could actually get a membership at the Y. I would like to go swim.
I'd
like to do
called,
like the water aerobics.
I think
something.
It was
aquaerobics.
Called the Gateway Program or the Scholarship Program. And then you can also, because they have all the different.
Do you have to have kids?
No.
Oh, good.
But they
okay.
have like the daycare, and then they also have the different programs that they offer for kids.
Right.
So whatever your percentage is what you would also pay for those classes and stuff.
Oh.
So you kids could still do some extra, you know, curricular activities without it costing you a lot of money if you can't afford it.
Well, that's good to know.
So, yeah, just
and you know something, talking about runaways, that's a really good outlet for families who are having problems, because then, you know, like a teenager or whomever could go to the Y.
Right.
And even if it's just to go for a dip or something in the pool,
right.
to get you know, away from the house, don't have to run away from the house, go ahead and go swimming a little bit, or maybe they could even play a little basketball.
Right.
They have basketball there, right?
Yeah, they do. They have
work it out, you know, work out well, your problems.
And then also another good thing that you can do together as a family to try to maybe help prevent it from getting that far.
Right.
Is try to have family dinners,
let
me grab that. I can't reach it from here.
Okay, I think we should bring the phone over to us. How's
can
that?
We talk? Hello?
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Doing
have
great.
A seat.
You were talking about, you know, the health insurance, and I have BCC, and I work, but my job doesn't carry health insurance.
Wow.
And what I have found out that when you apply at BCC and you go there for medical assistance and stuff, I found out that from my experiences that I pay in so much money to see specialists that sometimes I can't even afford to go there and then to go to MCV to see the specialist because I had to take an MRI, mm-hmm. and an MRI cost $8,500. They had me on code 4 or code 5. I pay a $5 co-payment, but after I had figured everything out and to take an MRI is $8,500, I would have to pay almost $4,500 out of my own pocket. And it's supposed to be a health insurance that to help people. And it seemed like to me the VCC hurt those who are working, who are still struggling, trying to make ends meet, trying to take care of their house, trying to pay the bills. Then you get sick and you go there and then you got another bill that's coming in $8,000-$9,000 and it's still keeping you in poverty.
You're right, and
so
it can make you sick.
You have a health insurance in the state of Virginia that says it helps the people, but it still keeps you in poverty, it keeps you poor.
Right, and what about though, Lynn was talking about the Fan Free Clinic. Have you tried them?
Well, I haven't been to the Fan Free Clinic. I have friends that work there.
Oh, okay.
But, you know, I have to have specialists that I have to go to because I have a pre-existing problem that that some people in the United States have and they're carrying on their kids' insurance, the people who have insurance, and they got the pre-existing problems with them. And they can get a specialist. But if you're working, your job don't carry insurance, and you have to find insurance, which I applied for Anthem insurance, they say, well, I have to pay $600 and some just to have insurance a month.
I know, but
so
of course it's expensive.
How can a person in this country can afford insurance when they say we don't want insurance, we don't want health insurance out of this country? We need health insurance because some people are working still can't afford health insurance.
That's true.
And then in certain states you got, and they got insurance in all these states, but it's still keeping people down and sick. So, you know, we need a universal health care that can help people. You know, if you got a sick country, how can a sick country can be well when the people are still sick to help the country?
You've got a very good point there.
And I will tell you this. At one time I didn't have health insurance either. And I have fibromyalgia and lupus, and I needed a doctor, and I couldn't afford it. So I went to the Fan Free Clinic. That's how I know so much about it. And they sent me to a rheumatologist, and they paid for everything for me. So give them a call. Maybe they can help with your specialist to help you out.
Okay, because I have a pre-existing problem.
I did, too, when I went there, and they helped me a lot.
I would appreciate that information.
Give them a call. Let us know how that goes.
All right, and we appreciate you. All right, thank you for calling.
Okay, I will do that. I'll give y'all a call. Next time I see y'all on 95, I will call you and let y'all know how it went.
Good, okay. We'll be here next week.
All right.
Have a good night.
Yes, and God bless.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
You too.
Bye-bye. Okay. Bye-bye. Glad to hear from you. We enjoy hearing from the community. It's important stuff. And
you're putting out some very useful information to the community, and that's
I think
that's
universal.
So
I think I think everybody should be able to have health care. It shouldn't matter. I mean, we are supposed to be one of the richest nations, and look at all of the people in our country that are in need, and we're not able to help them.
I know something that actually is, it's not going to cure you, but it sure could help you, and that is listening to some really good music. And so with that in mind, I would love to have Evelyn Quaye, accompanied by Christopher Andrews, to sing a song, maybe two if she will. And then we're going to talk to her just a little bit to find out a little bit more about her musical background. Okay, and so if you would please.
Take it away.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes each one, she passes those. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently, that when she passes each one, she passes goes ah. Oh, but he watches so sadly. How can he tell her he loves her? Yes, he would give his heart gladly, but each day as she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Dark and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes he smiles, but she doesn't see. So sadly, how can he tell her he loves her? Yes, he would give his heart gladly, but each day as she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Long and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes he smiles, but she doesn't see. No, she doesn't see. No, she doesn't see. No, she doesn't see. Okay.
Yeah. Sound good to you?
If you ever plan to motor west, ooh, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Hey, yes, get your kicks on Route 66. Well, it winds from Chicago to L.A., more than 2,000 miles all the way. Hey, yes, get your kicks on Route 66. Well, it winds through St. Louis and Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City is mighty pretty. You see Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona. Don't forget Winona, Kingman, Barstow, San Bernardino. Oh, 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 yeah. Won't you get here to this timely tip? Ooh, when you make that California trip. Hey, yes, get your kicks on Route 66. Thank you. in Joplin, Missouri, in Oklahoma City is mighty pretty. You see Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona. Don't forget Winona, Kingman, Barstow, San Bernardino. Whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah. Won't you get here to this timely tip? Ooh, when you make that California trip. Yeah, yes, get your kicks on Route 66. Whoa, yes, I said get your kicks on Route 66. Woo, yes, I said get your kicks on Route 66.
Wow, that was very, very nice.
Woo! Thank you, Evelyn Quaye. Woo! And Christopher Andrews, don't want to forget you. And so I wanted to ask you, Evelyn, where is your show tomorrow?
It's going to be at 231 Bistro in Petersburg, Virginia.
Petersburg. And what is it?
231 Bistro.
231 Bistro.
Bistro, yes.
All right. If anybody's around that area, or you might want to just go to that area so you can see Evelyn live.
Do you play at like events? Like, can somebody hire you to sing at
a party or a wedding?
Yes. How would they contact you to be able to do that?
They could either go to Reverb Nation. My Reverb Nation site is www.reverbnation/Evelyn Quaye, or they could email me at portraitsbyramel@yahoo.com.
And that's R-E-M-E-L, right?
Portraits by R-E-M-E-L. R-E-M-E-L, yes.
Okay, sounds great. And so you do a lot of gigs, don't you?
Yes, yes. Yes, so, I play, I sing jazz and blues. Sometimes I solo, sometimes I sing with a partner. Like tonight, I'm lucky to have Christopher Andrews here, who is an excellent guitarist.
Yes.
I also sing with a band called King Edward and the Beatties Band, which is based in Richmond. They've been around since the 1960s,
wow.
I believe.
Well, we'll have to have them on one time. We won't be able to fit them in this little studio here.
A lot of people.
But in the springtime, we start actually doing tape shows, and we do them outdoors, out in Short Pump. I'm on about 2.5 acres. Lots of foliage, and it looks beautiful. We do shows there. And in fact, hopefully next Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday nights, we're going to have a tape show that'll be playing that was taped over where I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. So if you catch the show, you'll see that. And we'd love to have you come do that. That'd be great.
Oh, yeah, that would be very
good. Yeah, you have two new fans right here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here.
Thank you.
I'm happy to be here.
I want to also say thank you to our director and producer, Leroy Wilkins, Jr. He's fabulous, and he has just come in here. We just started working with him recently, and he's made so much of a difference for the show, and we're really appreciating him.
And next week we're going to talk more about teens and runaways.
About Runaway. Yeah, I'm hoping to have a guest to come on to talk, you know, who's more knowledgeable.
I just wanted to put out there, if there's any teen that's watching us,
yes,
that may be in that situation, if you'd like to come and talk, we'd love to have you here. You can send myself an email. It's lynnclark70@gmail.com. Or you can send one to my mom, which is one, you tell yours.
O-N-E-D-I-S-I-P-L, onedisciple@aol.com. But, you know, I think most teens that are runaways are trying to stay hidden.
Not so, always.
No?
Not always.
Okay, well.
They may just be trying to stay hidden from their family, but they may still like to come out, or maybe they were once a teen runaway.
That's true.
And they'd like to talk about what their experience
was
like and maybe help somebody that has found themselves in the situation that they had gone through.
Okay. So that's cool. I'm going to work on that guidance counselor at the elementary school. I think that's only up to like fifth or sixth grade
fifth
over there.
Grade.
Fifth grade. That's kind of young.
But they're still guidance counselors.
She may still have
They've
some input.
They've still been instructed and trained. So we'll have some more entertainment for you next week.
Right. And I do want to say a special thanks to our guest star, Evelyn Quaye.
Yes, thank you so much.
And to her wonderful accompaniment there, the guitarist. It's Christopher Andrews. And you can, I guess, hit her up on Reverb Nation.
Yes,
yes. Nation. Reverb Nation, Evelyn Quaye.
Yes, or Portraits by Ramil
at right.
yahoo.com.
Or you can friend me on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, Facebook.
friend me on Facebook, yes. And I'll put you in touch with her, and that'll work too. Michelle Casale, M-I-C-H-E-L-E, only one L, C-A-S-A-L-E, Casale. And I'll put you in touch with her. And anyway, we were talking earlier today about relationships, mm-hmm. runaways being the main topic for today, and
try
communication.
To keep yourself safe.
Keeping safe.
Yep.
Communication is the key, right? In yep. every relationship. Yep. I don't care what kind of relationship it may be. You have to have communication open, otherwise there's no real relationship. And that's with a sister, brother, a lover, a mother, a father, a teacher, your pet.
And you know like what? Pets. When I was younger and I used to go on field trips and stuff, they used to always say a buddy system.
Right.
Well, you don't necessarily have to have two people together, but if you're going to go out, say you're going on a date for the first time, let one of your friends know where you're going to go or, you know, who you're going to go with.
Somebody better know.
To check in with
I remember
you,
your
you
first
know?
Date.
I don't even remember my first date.
I remember because I went to walk the dog so I could write down his license number and everything.
I remember. And so once again, we'll be here next week.
And we want to say thank you for watching. Thank you to Michael Casale for also doing a video this evening.
Have a safe and happy week.
Yeah.
Do something nice for yourself this week.
And do something nice for somebody else. Don't forget to smile.
And thank you for watching. And we hope to see you next week.
And take somebody's cart from them in the parking lot, okay? They don't need it anymore. It'd be a nice thing to do. Okay, God bless you. Keep you safe. Keep watching.
We'll
every
see you next
Friday,
week.
Every Friday from 7:30 to 8:30. And Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday nights, 11 to 11:30. Wow, we're really out there now, aren't we?
Yeah, kind of scared. Yeah.